Okay. So, here's the thing. Jaska told me to bring my fishing equipment and the camera and meet him here somewhere. But I have no clue where. Jaska! Oh, wait a minute. I see his rod there. That means he can't be far away. Jaska, where are you?
5 more minutes.
It's time to go fishing.
It's not spring yet.
Yes, it is. What? Rivers are open. Spring is here. I even saw the first mosquitoes.
You might be right. 5 more minutes.
Alright, hey everyone, we are at the moment fishing in Leån river. It's in Hälsinglands, close to Ljusdals. We are here and trying to catch some big trout, so I hope I need my GoPro. And of course I have been making last night trout flies. It's spring, it's kind of a bit early still. And here on this river, this is purely just catch and release. So if I will catch something, it will go back instantly. Of course, I will try to get a good video material for you guys to enjoy. But the main idea is it's going back. And by the way, I'm also testing a new 9.9 feet class 7 rod. Thanks to Peter in Guideline for a cap, and Whitlock Sportfiske for actually fixing me a rod, and of course Ljusdals Fiskeområde for letting us fish here in this nice and beautiful area. And a little bit about that catch and release. So of course you would maybe want to use hooks without no barbs if you have those, that kind of flies or material. I'm now fishing with, like I said earlier, class 7 rods or class 7 rod, and with floating lines, because here can be really nice nice size monsters. There is swimming in that lake, has been seen over 5 kilo trouts. And that would be nice to catch on this kind of rod. Or why not? I'm just showing what kind of tippet I'm having. So 9 feet. And this says 6.7 kilos. Should be good enough. Oho! It ate my fly! Did you saw? So, this kind of fly, this almost looks like a pike fly, works for a big trout. Just made this last night. Let's give a go. Alrighty. So, this fly and start from the top neck of this river. Let's see. This is quite nice and shallow area. I can see underwater really well. Fly looks great. Awesome. Of course, I start throwing these close areas first. Never know where they are hiding. This fly goes fairly nicely in the surface when I'm pulling it. Fish! And there it is. First fish on. Oh, it's a pike. Let's take this mister home. This is a trout water, so we definitely don't want this fellow to eat trout babies or any other grayling babies. And this is just purely put and take water. So I have a now special permit to actually take these kind of fishes away from here. And this will go for food, so this is not gonna go anywhere waste. I'm gonna take it with my net. Small and nice pike. Let's take it to the shore. There. And now it's already loose. So that's maybe 1.5 kilo pike. There. And now I'm sadly to say this fellow is my fly. Yeah. Is it same fly still?
No.
What do you guys think? I just made this. Oh well. Alright, and it seems my fly got, or actually lost, one eye in the battle against Mr. Pig, but it's still going actually quite straight. All right, here we are walking on the nice forest road with Rita. We are going to the Leån Stugan. It's really nice forest road. You can hear the river. Trouts are singing in the trees.
Close enough anyway.
Yeah. And soon we will see. This is awesome looking place. There's a small side creek on this side. The main river is on the left side. When I first time I came here, I was thinking about, holy moly, if I would be old and big and rich person, I would so want to buy this kind of cabin on this kind of river. Because this is a good spot. There is a grayling and a big trouts. And now they informed me actually, hey, you can rent this place. There's a awesome looking stream. Bridge. Clean, clear water. Oh boy.
Let's go to the bridge. Or near it. I'm gonna anyway start fishing at the bridge, so I don't want to go and spook the fishes away. On the other side there is one of these kappa hooks, so small logwood type fireplace. And I'm gonna try to bombard this area with a pink fly. Now, before I'm actually going near that bridge. Because there might be a good sized trout waiting. Just there. You never know.
Fish. Let's see what it is. It's a harm.
Put that one there. And that one there. So. I'm gonna take my gloves off so I don't get cold. And of course, always remember to water your hands when you're touching a fish. So. If you want to. So there it is. No need. Goodbye.
Did you saw? Whoa, what a jump! Fish! Oh shit! And again, I wet my hands. Come on. There. Wait.
This is much browner. Goodbye. There we go. Here we go. And same thing, wetting my hands. Fly off. No. There. There you go. Really, really beautiful looking. And there. Goodbye. Come back when you're bigger.
Oh. I'm so done, I'm so spent. I've been here on the beautiful river for 2 days now. Now it's Sunday. Rita needs to go to work and the clock is 9 o'clock in the night or evening. So I think we're just gonna eat some sausages and then go home, sadly. I think this Leån River is having the absolutely tremendous potential to be the best trout river in the whole Hälsinglands area here in Sweden. So nice water. People have been building up those places where they can go and spawn. And here is a lot of these small trout babies, as you have seen. I have caught several already. And I saw a couple of big ones. They just come up in the surface and go instantly back to the bottom. I've been trying already nymphs, big streamers, small streamers, even dry flies, nothing works. So I think the big ones are only biting at evening time or night time when it's like a bit loomy, dark or something. Ah, better luck next time. I think we need to come here later. Check that cabin what I filmed earlier. Yeah, that would be something to rent it and be here all weekend. Well, let's see how it goes then. Now it went like this. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. And see you next time. If you want to be a really nice person, subscribe, because that helps me a lot to grow my channel. And like the video if you liked the did like the video. And have a good one. Bye bye. I have one more thing to say. Super big thanks to Peter in Guideline Fly Fishing, Sweden. Keep doing what you are doing. You are awesome dude. Absolutely heartwarming fellow. Then special thanks also goes to Whitlock Sportfiske for handling quite nicely a difficult fin. Of course I'm not mentioning who that difficult fin is, but yeah, it's better like that. And Ljusdals Fiskeområde for letting us fish here in Leån. Absolutely stunning place and river. Thank you. And this is my first food after morning porridge. So good to have something warm to eat. We have been so busy fishing all the time, so no time to eat. I really like this.
One of the really good sites of fishing. Although mine is a little bit, well, tight on one side. They say this one is really good for your sunburns.